We want to find the quotient using base 10 blocks. We have 3 and 4 tenths divided by 4 tenths, which means we want to determine how many 4 tenths there are in 3 and 4 tenths. Because we're working with decimals, we'll define the base 10 blocks as you see here on the right. We'll begin by modeling 3 and 4 tenths, which would be 3 flats for 3 and 4 longs for 4 tenths. So here's our model for 3 and 4 tenths. Because we're dividing by 4 tenths, which again can be modeled using 4 longs as we see here, to determine our quotient, we want to determine how many copies or how many sets of 4 longs are in 3 flats and 4 longs. Well, here's one copy of 4 longs or 4 tenths. Here's a second copy of 4 longs or 4 tenths. Here's another copy of 4 longs or 4 tenths. Notice here we can take two of these longs and two of these longs here to make a fourth copy of 4 longs or 4 tenths. Here's a fifth copy, a sixth copy, a seventh copy, and finally an eighth copy of 4 longs or 4 tenths in 3 and 4 tenths. Now notice how we have these two longs remaining. So we need to be careful here. Remember, we're looking for copies of 4 tenths, which consist of 4 longs. We only have two longs, so we have two of the 4 longs needed for another copy of 4 tenths, which means we have 2/4 or half a copy of 4 tenths here. So these two longs represent half a copy of 4 tenths, and 1/2 is equivalent to 5 tenths, or 0.5 using decimal notation, which means our quotient is 8 and 5 tenths, or 8.5. Which means there are 8 and 5 tenths, or 8.5 copies of 4 tenths in 3 and 4 tenths. To emphasize this, let's also write the corresponding multiplication problem, which would be 8.5, or 8 and 5 tenths, times 0.4, or times 4 tenths, equals 3.4, or 3 and 4 tenths. 8.5, or 8 and 5 tenths copies of 4 tenths is equal to 3 and 4 tenths. I hope you found this helpful.